Railway Sestina. You and I had walked along those tracks just months before. The dead brown leaves crunched beneath our fearless feet. Our path glowed beneath the moonlight. We held hands. Far off, a whistle blew its shrill alarm. The train approached, then passed. We went our way. It's summer when two more come by this way, perhaps already doomed. The railroad tracks lead from a party to her home. His arm wraps close around her waist. This time the leaves are lush and green. She tucks one of her hands in his back pocket. In wait, the psychopath watches their approach and blocks their path. He takes their money, finds a cunning way to use their belts and his to bind their hands and feet. He boldly stops them in their tracks with just an old screwdriver. When he leaves, they work the knots, but he's back soon, one arm cradling a large rock. She sees alarm flash across her lover's face, the path splatter red with blood and brain. Believes she'll die here too, but no. He goes away once he's raped and beaten her, backtracks the way he came. On the news, her hands still shake. As cameras pan her face, those hands, I think of us, 19, of how your arm wrapped round me then. I think of tracks, the ways we might have crossed the psychopath, of how, unlike them, we'd have walked away unscathed. The heart believes what it believes, and stubbornly, naively, mine believes so long as you're with me, his brutal hands can never touch me. You'll always find a way to subdue him, or maybe we disarm this man together, choose a path of more resistance, fight, then flee those tracks. But when you free my hands, say, run away. I cannot leave without you. We must go arm in arm, or not at all. Our paths are joined. We follow in their tracks.